Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. Last time we completed some more of the scout tasks for the Black River map, but more importantly, we reached rank 8, which unlocks the off-road tires for the heavy-duty and highway class trucks. In this episode, I'd like to complete the contract Not a Drill, so let's go back to the Smithfield Dam garage and start upgrading the White Western Star. I'm going to install the 2100T engine upgrade, which we picked up last episode, the off-road gearbox, the raised suspension upgrade, and I'll sell the standard suspension. I'll go with the 47-inch UOD2 tyres, as they have the best performance in mud, and I'll sell the standard highway tyres. I'll install the engageable diff lock upgrade and sell the standard unlocked version, and the engageable all-wheel drive upgrade. I'll install a loading crane, the low saddle, and I'll add the roof fog lights to help with night visibility. This is one of the faster trucks available, so of course it needs a matching red paint job. The only real downside of the White Western Star is it cannot have a crane, a flatbed, and tow a trailer at the same time, which is something the Fleet Star can do. To elaborate a little on why I feel it's worth waiting to unlock the off-road tyres, if we take a look at the stats for the tyres which are typically available for these trucks, there is a significant jump in mud performance between the all-terrain and the best of the off-road tyres, the UOD2. These actually almost match the MHS1 mud tyres, which are only available on trucks like the Paystar 5070. The first stage of Not a Drill requires us to deliver two loads of metal beams to the drilling site, and we'll need a 5-slot trailer for the second stage. We left the GMC 9500 connected to a 5-slot trailer earlier on, so we can unload the last of the cargo from that and use that for this contract. The loading crane will not reach far enough to load cargo in the last few slots of the trailer, so it will be necessary to disconnect the trailer and park alongside near the loading bay. To get to the drilling site from the town, we could either make our way back past the lumber mill and approach from the south, or take a slightly longer route through the swamp and approach from the north, which avoids the steep hill near the lumber mill. The route through the swamp is slightly easier in my opinion, as even with the upgraded engine, the heavy load will cause the White Western Star to stall out going up the steep hill near the lumber mill. With the first stage complete, we'll need to head back into Smithville Dam to pick up the oiler rig drill. small loading crane will struggle to lift the drill if the arm is fully extended, and while it can get the job done, we're not going to win any points for style here. This is an example of where a lack of torque with a heavy load is far more of an issue than traction, as once stopped, the truck really struggles to get going again. The final stage requires us to deliver a massive construction rig semi-trailer, which is located at the factory. While the White Western Star is capable of towing it, we'd need to install a high saddle, and the P16 is already at the factory as we left it there after completing pipe drain. Going slow and steady and taking the sharper corners as wide as possible is the order of the day here. Crossing the river with the construction trailer is the shortest route back to the drill site, but it can be risky. I suggest avoiding the mud islands as forward progress is so slow that it is possible for the trailer to catch on one of the fallen trees and you can get completely stuck here. With the trailer delivered, we've completed not a drill and received a nice little bonus. I'll leave it here for this episode. Thanks for watching.